his neighbor's house burnt to the ground. I just emailed him to tell him I'm not doing good. His neighbor's house burnt to the ground. God, how? He lives in the boonies. And I told you, moose and he has a tunnel. It's got to be the neighbors, but the family, the kids that have invited him over for the holidays. Because he's not close to his family. Even less so than ever before, if you catch my drift. My mother's eating nothing. Just a cottage cheese, that's it. And a drink. You're gonna put her in the hospital and feed her intravenously and wonder. I'm not gonna just sugarcoat it. And then they're gonna section her. There's nothing I can do. The writing's on the wall. Few are gonna survive. Joe's gonna survive because he's strong. I'm going through this with my mother and I'm expected to also murder my dog. Did their house burn to the ground? They said that fire trucks and police and everything have been there all day. They live in a big, beautiful house like him. It's gotta be the ones who's invited him. It's gotta be. I think he doesn't even have it. They live next door. It's one of those things where you have. I bet you it's the ones that invited him over. I don't know. Maybe not. He doesn't live close to people. I know he doesn't. He has acres and acres of land. And he's happy. He's happy alone. He has me, and that's enough for him. It's not even there, it's just from a distance. Because he's at peace with himself. And he's not going through the living hell that I'm going through. Sure, I can't view it as I don't appreciate. You know, he says appreciate what you have. Yeah, I'm sorry, Joe. But you, thousands of miles away, being able to turn to you only from a distance, is not enough for me. It might be enough for you. It's not enough to keep me strong. Not under these circumstances. Of course, that doesn't mean I don't appreciate you. Of course I do. Neighbor's house burnt to the ground. Unbelievable. Not unbelievable. Nothing's unbelievable. Just watching Mike and Molly and laughing. It's a miracle I can laugh. It's one I haven't seen. It was called Mike Likes Briefs, and it was all about sex and him trying to get Molly pregnant, and they're just so open about everything. Of course, her mother and Vince and mother's boyfriend or husband, and they didn't get married. It's just, they're just so open about sex and Mike trying to get Molly pregnant. And you lose all the romance. It's just, okay, get on your back. It's time to have sex. We're going to make a baby. But it was fun. The next one I'd seen part of it, where they go on the adventure and they pretend to drive in a Rolls Royce and pretend that they can afford shit like that. And then they get trapped in a hotel that probably costs $50,000 a night for a room or something. And they have sex in one of the rooms. They sneak up in the elevator, but then they get trapped and have to walk down 72 flights of stairs, and they're both obese, Mike more than Molly. And they're just so real. They're so real. So open about everything. I wound up beating both meatball subs. Wouldn't it be ironic if they get me sick, if they weren't cooked enough? But it is a high-class place I got them from. But still, you never know. I don't even want to eat that. I eat organic hamburger. I got them for her to have one, and then I get one. Just like if I get something, or a sandwich at Dunkin' Donuts, I get one for myself, even though I really don't want it, if I get it for her. She didn't want the ice cream. I ate three yesterday and one today. She didn't want anything. I even said, if I go out today, I will get something good to eat. Is there anything you would want? I'll get you anything you want. I don't want anything. Yeah, well, they're going to feed you intravenously, and then they're going to put you in the nut house, Mom. There's nothing that I can do about it. I'm also going to have to probably put Omar to sleep.